This video discusses how to solve Hess's law type problems. This is an indirect method for determining delta H of a reaction. When you're presented with these problems, they're going to look something like this. The equation up top that's in bold is what I like to call the target equation. This is the one that you're trying to determine delta H of reaction for. The equations down below, these ones right here, I'm going to number them. I'm going to call them 1 and 2. These ones right here are what I like to call the working equations. Your goal for this type of problem is you're trying to figure out how do you modify equation 1 and equation 2 so that when you add them together, you end up with a target equation up top. The strategy that I use to go about doing these types of problems is I look at the formulas of the reactants and the products in my target equation. I'm going to do that right now. So I'm looking at my reactants. I'm on the left-hand side of the target equation. I've got this C2H4O, and I also have oxygen gas as my two reactants. I want to find where do these reactants show up in my working equations 1 and 2. So if I start with the C2H4O, I can only find it in one spot in all of equations 1 and 2. The only spot it is right here on the left-hand side. Oxygen gas shows up in two places. I've got it here, and I got it here. So I'm just looking at where do all of my reactants show up in my working equations, and I circled them in red. I'm going to do the same thing for the products of my target equation. I'm going to circle them in blue. I have two products here. I've got carbon dioxide and I've got 2 moles of water. I'm looking for those formulas. I'm ignoring the coefficients in front. I just want to find where are carbon dioxide and water in my working equations 1 and 2. Carbon dioxide shows up in one spot right here in equation 2. And water is in two spots. I've got it here, and I've got it here. Anything that I didn't circle represents what we would call a reaction intermediate. It's something that when I add my two equations together, 1 and 2, it needs to cancel so that it doesn't show up in my target equation. My next step is I'm coming up with a strategy. How am I going to modify equation 1 and 2 so that when I add them together, I end up with my target equation up top? I'm going to start with reaction number 1. And what I notice about this equation here is that those 2 moles of C2H4O, that reactant only shows up in one spot in all of my working equations. To get my target equation, I want just 1 mole up top. In equation number 1, I have 2 moles of it. I have that 2 in front. If I want to match my target equation, I need to change the coefficient. I need to change it from a 2 into a 1. That's my clue that what I need to do for equation number 1 is I'm going to take everything and multiply it by a half. That's going to match that one reactant, C2H4O, so that it matches my target equation up top. I'm going to start following my strategy. I'm going to take equation 1, and I want to rewrite it, multiplying everything by 1/2. So if I start with the 2 moles of C2H4O, when I multiply by a half, I'm left with just 1. So I've got 1 mole of C2H4O. Liquid. My 2 moles of water are going to multiply by 1/2 so that I have just 1. My 2 moles of C2H6O are going to become just 1 after I multiply by a half. And I have 1 mole of oxygen gas up top. When I multiply by a half, it's going to become a half. So I rewrote equation 1, multiplying everything by 1/2. I'm going to follow the same strategy for delta H of reaction. My delta H of reaction, I'm going to call it delta H1. It started as 610.5 kilojoules per mole. I need to multiply that by the same factor. So I'm going to do 1/2 times 610.5 kilojoules. Next, I want to come up with my strategy for equation 2. I'm looking at this, so I've got carbon dioxide, water, and oxygen are my reactants and products showing up in my second working equation. The one that I'm paying close attention to is the carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide only shows up in one spot in all of my working equations. I need to get it to match my target equation up top. In the target equation, I've got 2 moles of carbon dioxide on the right. In my working equation, the 2 moles of carbon dioxide are on the left. This is telling me that if I want to match what I have up top, the coefficient is the same, but it's on the wrong side. I'm going to take equation number 2 and I'm going to reverse it so that my 2 moles of carbon dioxide are on the right. This is my strategy that I'm going to follow for equation number 2, and I'm going to rewrite it to see what I'm left with. So I'm going to rewrite equation 2. I want to reverse this equation, so I'm going to take the products, C2H6O, and make it a reactant, along with the 3 moles of oxygen gas. My reactants, the 2 moles of carbon dioxide, are going to show up on the right-hand side when I reverse the equation, along with 3 moles of water. What happens to my delta H for equation 2 is that when I reverse the equation, the number stays the same, but the sign changes. It started as 2056.5 kilojoules. That number is going to stay the same, but I'm going to add a negative sign when I reverse the equation, 2056.5 kilojoules. My goal here is I came up with a strategy to modify equation 1 and 2 so that when I add these together, my net result is the target equation. To figure out what I'm left with after I add these equations together, the first thing that I'm going to do is cancel reaction intermediates. Reaction intermediates are the things that show up on both sides of the equation. So the first thing that I notice here is the C2H6O. I've got 1 mole on the right on this side and 1 mole on the left, which is going to cancel in reactions 1 and 2. The other things that are showing up on both sides are the water. I've got 1 mole of water on the left in equation 1. It's going to cancel with these 3 moles of water that I have on the right side, but only 1 mole is going to cancel, so I'm going to end up with 3 minus 1, or 2 moles, on the right. Same idea with the oxygen gas. I have a 1/2 mole of oxygen gas on the right-hand side in equation 1, which is going to cancel with my oxygen gas on the left-hand side in equation 2. I'm going to do 3 moles minus 1/2, which is going to leave me with 2.5 moles of oxygen gas, which is the same thing as 5/2 if I were to show that as a fraction. Everything else is what I'm left with, and I'll just underline the things that I'm left with. I'm going to carry down everything that I'm left with that doesn't cancel. So I've got my 1 mole of C2H4O. And my other reactant is this 2.5 moles of oxygen gas, which is the same thing as 5/2. Plus 2 moles of carbon dioxide is one product, and 2 moles of water is my other. What you'll notice here is I ended up with the target equation. I've got 1 mole of C2H4O plus the 5/2, which is the same thing as 2.5 moles of oxygen gas, gives me 2 moles of carbon dioxide and 2 moles of water. My whole goal of this type of reaction is I'm trying to figure out what is delta H for this reaction, my target equation. Hess's law says that if I sum the two equations together after my modifications, so if I do delta H1 times 1/2 plus delta H2 with that negative sign, that sum is going to give me delta H of reaction. So to calculate delta H in this problem here, I'm going to take 1/2 times my 610.5 kilojoules, and I'm going to add that together with my negative 2056.5 kilojoules. What I end up with here, my delta H for my target equation here, I got a large negative number, negative 1,751.2 kilojoules. So I hope this problem helps you as you work through your take-home quiz and gives you an example of how to use Hess's law.